During a disaster event, the days and the hours before a hurricane makes landfall are crucially important.
Disaster decisions are often made without having a full picture.
The key thing for us is not having bottlenecks.
With Earth AI, we're able to make much more informed decisions to utilize the funding that we have in a more effective way and to effectively help save lives.
I'm Catherine Tilliard. I lead the catastrophe modeling team here at McGill and Partners. Our role is to support clients in understanding and managing their risks, such as hurricanes, wildfires, earthquakes, floods.
My name is Federico Barreras, and I'm a humanitarian manager at GiveDirectly. I help GiveDirectly send cash to people right after a disaster strikes, or sometimes even before that happens. At GiveDirectly, we've been working with Google Research for over 2 years now to try to identify when shocks are about to hit people and send them cash before it happens. The idea of anticipatory action is to make people more resilient and better prepared to shocks so they can cope with them much better.
There's so many different users during a disaster event. Insurers trying to understand what properties are at risk need to communicate that information. They need to deploy their resources. With Bellwether, we have found an amazing partner because our mindsets are very aligned on that in terms of being very innovative, taking a very complex challenge and solving for it with a real purpose about supporting our clients.
We have been partnering with Google Research, who developed Google Flood Hub. Flood Hub provides us 5 to 7 day forecasts that allow us to know when a flood is going to hit a specific area. We also use other Google Research tools, such as Sky. When disasters hit, it could be an earthquake, it could be a tsunami. And we use the Google Research geospatial tool to identify people impacted by the shock.
We use complex scientific and engineering models that help us understand where the hazards will occur, how frequent, how severe they'll be, what properties and what assets are in harm's way. The thing that really excites us about working with the Bellwether team is it's empowering our clients to have this data at their fingertips, to put those very technical tools and those data sets in the hands of the decision makers, which allows them to respond and support their customers more quickly. It's a game changer.
With Earth AI, now we're able to have much more granular triggers and much more granular forecasting that allow us to identify exactly communities or villages that are going to be affected by hazards such as floods or droughts. This is crucial for us because it allows us to send cash in a more effective way. The Google Research AI geospatial tool will allow us to have maps where we will see where we have to react, where we have to operate in a very fast way. In the year 2024, we saw how the first triggers activated in Nigeria, and it was incredible to see how accurate they were. We started sending cash to people only 48 hours after the triggers activated. When I traveled to Nigeria last October, I saw people who had used it not only to evacuate their houses when they were about to be flooded, but also to build rafters and protect the little that they were able to harvest that year.
Currently, a lot of the insurers have to wait for that information, and they're doing what we're doing. They're looking for data, they're looking for information, and now they can have it at their fingertips to make those decisions in real time. AI is here. Embrace the technology. We have found that technology is a huge enabler to help us solve these complex challenges. It's just going to allow us to do our jobs in a much more efficient way and deliver solutions to our clients much quicker and in a much more targeted way.
Earth AI can be a game changer for us. It can allow us to identify people affected by a shock much faster than before. It can help us sending cash to people's hands right in the aftermath of a disaster. AI can particularly play an important role in the work done around climate adaptation. We're going to be able to identify people at risk in a better way, and we're going to be able to give them assistance right at the time that they need it.